think that's something you know as a child, probably. I remember my grandma giving me my first coloring book in crayons. It was like the greatest thing ever. You know, I don't think I ever looked back after that. It was always there. I remember going on vacation when I was probably 10 with my parents up north to, you know, one of the bazillion lakes up there, and picking up like a Women's Day magazine or something, and they were telling how to paint with acrylic paints. So we went to the local dime store and my mom bought me a canvas and acrylic paints, and I taught myself how to use acrylic paints, and from then on I probably never ever looked back. So I don't remember not being an artist or wanting to be an artist or feeling like I was an artist. I think they just show up in my mind and in my heart, and some of them have to come out. I don't have a choice. They're in control. I'm not. I've had a few paintings recently that, and they ended up being very large. They came to me, and they were maybe inspired or something that was passionate for me or something that was near and dear to my heart. And just recently it's more of a sculpture than a painting. And it came to me last fall, and it nudged at me until I finally did it and got it out of me, and it was called She Is Strong. And I think it was generated from, I have a very sick niece right now, and it was just something that kind of projected her strength, but through my vision of how I see her, and you know, truly all the strong women in my life. It was just something that I wanted out. Sometimes I put words on canvases. Every once in a while, there'll be some sort of poem that will go with an image that has to come out. I don't know how you explain that, because I don't think there's an explanation why it happens. It just does, and you know, you're an artist, so you probably get that. I don't know. Sometimes it just is there, and it has to come out. Sometimes you have to have a painting for a particular reason. I think those are a bit harder to do. You know, when you're forced to paint for a reason or in a certain timeline, or so it's much. You know, in the perfect world, it's much better to just be able to paint what you're feeling or what your vision is or in the time span that you want to do it, but you know, it's generally not a perfect world, so a lot of times you're forcing yourself to paint things, and sometimes it works out and sometimes it doesn't, but I find that the things that are very passionate to me are the things that always come out okay. You know, I'm usually more pleased with those, something that I feel that I need to get out. Not always what I am trying to project out of a painting is what other people see in it, but as long as I can step back from it and go, that's the purpose of this piece, then I feel like, okay, I'm finished and I've succeeded. And well, now I think the most frightening thing is then putting it out to public eyes. Even if it's not something I did personally for someone else, I'm always nervous when the first person looks at it that's, you know, not in my family, that is going to be polite no matter what, you know. But I think that's the hardest part of being an artist, because it's very personal and it's generally part of your heart that you're projecting off onto a canvas, and if people don't see it the way you see it or feel about it the way you feel about it, or God forbid are critical of it, it's a little hard. It's like, you know, a very personal thing that you've got to kind of try to toughen up and deal with. In Essence of Time, I use a lot of acrylic, and it dries fast. I used to do a lot of mural work, and I'm starting to do more again, and again, it has to dry fast. So I teach a lot, so again, it has to dry fast, so I use a lot of acrylic. So I love Monet and Renoir, and that's my favorite. I like the color, I like the movement, you know. I think they're, for my own personal viewing, I think they're more interesting to look at. There's a lot of movement happening. I certainly respect people who can take a still life or whatever and make it look like a photograph. I think that's fascinating, but I find for my own self that I look at it and I'm fascinated, and then I'm maybe bored, if that's the best. You know, I like things where you can see more movement. I like where you can you know, stare at it forever and maybe see something different every time. It gives you a little bit different perspective.